Another Divi layout or Divi module customizations. In this video, we will be using Divi blur. So I will show you how you can customize and go beyond with the default styling on Divi. So are you interested in that? If yes, stay tuned because I'm gonna show you how. 1, 2, 3. Hey guys, so this is the initial process layout that I did. I'm actually planning to revamp this design, but when I show it to my boss, she told me that she's contented with the design, so I might come up with another tutorial for my revamp version. So for now, I will just show with you how did I did this one without using any custom JavaScript. So purely, we will just use two modules, and I'm gonna show you how did I did this one. And for the buttons, if you are not, I mean, this one is too basic for you because I haven't really done any styling on that buttons. So if you want to come up with more better version of these buttons, then using a custom CSS would be also a good start. So how did I did this one? So first, let me open my flywheel so I can demonstrate that into my local computer. So let's turn on the flywheel and okay. And then let me just copy that link over there. Okay, so I'm ready in my admin. Let me create an empty page. Call that process something. Oh, okay, process layout and use the page builder. And we will be only using two modules, by the way. So the first module that you can use or you will be using is a blur. Okay, so I'm gonna follow this kind of style in here. So stage one, so I'm gonna call that like stage one. Oh, super bad with naming thing. So copy, let me just copy that one. And then for the, like, I need to remove, download that picture. By the way, you can also use SVG if you want. You can come up with a custom CSS if you want. But just for, you know, faster layout process, for faster process, the image would be a good start. So click the image or you can use an icon. But for now, I'm going to use an image just for aesthetic purposes. So open that and then upload an image, and then for the design tab, I want it to be on the left. Okay, and this one is too kind, I mean, that is too small for me in this icon. So I'm gonna put, you can use a custom CSS or you can also set a you can also set the width in here, so like with 100px, or let's just make it 80px. That's too big for me, I think. Yeah, 50px. But like, if you are asking my suggestion, it's really better if you use a custom class. So let's mimic this like this one. So okay, copy. And then for the border thing, I will add a left border. But right now it is kind of too, I mean, there's a lot of space in here going on. So that's fine. I'm going to show you later how we can fix that. So save. And then we need this learn more thing or learn more button. So how you can do that? So we need another module. By the way, I duplicated this blurb modules. Like, I don't want to do this process because they are just both the same. Okay. So now I'm gonna add another module called accordion. Yeah, is it accordion? I just forgot the name. It is toggle. So for the toggle, I'm gonna click this dynamic thing in here, and then looked for a manual custom field name. So we copied that one, and then for the before, I wanted to add a button called learn more. Okay, learn more, and then button. And if you want to add styling onto your buttons, we can come up with a class in there, and let me call that sample or my BTN. And we will copy that. I'm going to save this class into my notepad so I can style the buttons later. Okay, so we have that, and then copy. And then I'm going to grab some few lorem ipsum placeholder in here. So lorem and boom. Okay. And let's get some few lorems in here and put it over here and save. And then let's do that on the other as well. I'm going to duplicate that one. So this guys, it looks super ugly right now, but we will fix this one later. So just bear with me, guys. So yeah, so we have that already. We duplicate the buttons. We already have four stages in there. And then let's save that and exit the Visual Builder. As you can see here, we already kind of like we're almost finished to the what we need. So we have the basic functions already. So this one, so this is basically we want, but we need to remove some few unnecessary styling for the toggle. So how you can do that? Okay, so to do that, we will need, okay, to do that, I'm gonna remove this icon over here. Click the design tab, go to the custom CSS, and then look for a so-called toggle icon. And again, you can always target the toggle icon class if you want to be more global like approach, but just the purpose of this presentations, let's just do the basic one. Okay, so we already have this one. I mean, the icons are already removed. Then I will remove these borders after. So to remove the borders, go to the design tab and then borders. And then this borderline, I want it to be zero. Okay, so borders is already gone. Now I need to revert or make the background white. Okay, so ta-da, it's already finished. Now I'm going to duplicate this. I'm going to copy this one. So copy modules, style, and then I think that can be extend instead of copy. So extend toggle styles, and I want it to extend it on the entire row. Okay, so it's ready, done, everything is so good. Now the next step would be I need to make this, I mean I need to remove this empty space in here. So how we can do that? Okay, so to do that, you can click this gear icon and you go to the sizing and make this content width to like probably 145, wherever you prefer. And then you make this module under like in this part. So if you want to make this empty thing over there, click the. Now, if you want to remove this empty spot over here, you can go to the design tab and go to the sizing and then work on this, like this thing over here. So I can come up with a static like size perhaps. So like that, so it will move on the left side. You can also play around like with the module alignment, but I want it to be on the left side. And also I forgot, like instead of putting a custom CSS in here, you can also put that into the image width. So we will add 50px there. Okay, and I'm gonna extend this one, copy and extend the blurb Okay, so we have that looked already. You can also, like, if you don't want this to be like that, you want to have a half slider on it. I mean, the process is still the same. You just need to come up with another module on the left side, and then this one. Let me know if you want me to create a tutorial on that. But once you're ready, like, follow this step here. I mean, the process is almost the same. You just need to rearrange the position. Okay, now we already have this, like, this layout. We already achieved the layout. And if you want to come up with a styling for your buttons, like here, you know, remember we added a class, right, called MyBTN. Okay, so instead of, if you want to have a styling there, we can add a styling into that custom CSS. So go to the WordPress dashboard, and then go to the Divi theme options. If you are using child theme, then put it on the styles.css. Okay, and then put it, let's say I'm gonna add a styling called my button. Just forgot the name. Wait, is it? Yeah, it's my BTN. And then I will remove the border to none, background is red, color is white, and height is 40px. And by the way, guys, this is a crazy bad design, I believe. I mean, if you want to really have a good design, you need to do not follow this layout. But I'm just showing with you, like, how you can come up with this with a custom styling for your buttons if you want to. So border radius of 5px, and I can actually come up with a back shadow of 10px by 5px by 5px by an RGB of 0000.118, and like that. I mean, just play around with the buttons, guys. I mean, the layout of your buttons. And yeah, this is kind of like, if you want to really come up with a good styling, just depends on you. I'm just giving you the core of this layout, how you can come up with this kind of design. And also, if you want to download the snippet, because I will provide a snippet there for the preview, the better version of this design, you can go into my website to download the .json file. Hope it helps.